Hello, I am Lee with Amazing Form. I'm continuing this conversation around Meras, the pillars of a thriving organization. This is the template that you can use as a strategy for your business and your organization's culture. What we now understand through the science of positive psychology is that if individuals thrive and flourish, then their organization and or community will thrive and flourish. So I'm up to the final element today the final pillar that will support your thriving organization. And that is a positive state of mind and emotion. How does this work? Now, before I do that, I just want to let you know that although I set it out as Meras, M-E-R-A-S, it is important to understand that it actually is not in any order. So they're not ranked as important. They're all important. They can stand alone or they can be one. What we now know is that human beings need to have all these five in order for them to flourish and thrive. So think of them as ingredients, if I may, in various doses that will create the right culture for you and your organization. So let's talk about the final one, positive state of mind and emotion. We now understand is that human beings are emotionally driven. We know that emotions are important for us. And sometimes a lot of the decisions that we actually make as individuals are based on our emotions. This is true. But we also understand is that we can, as individuals, control these emotions. We don't have to be triggered by external things in order to control them. But that's on an individual basis. How does this translate to organizations? Organizations that create an environment where people are able to express a positive emotion, are encouraged to have a positive state of mind, are more likely to thrive and flourish as an organization. So positive state of mind is that sense of curiosity or that sense of wonder. And if we had that state of mind, we're more inclined to be positive emotionally, from satisfaction to happiness to joy. So if we can create that in our space, then that's what we can help our individuals to bring that in. So, you know, how do we actually measure that? That's an important thing. How do you know when your people are in that space of positive mindset and positive emotion? Well, there's a vibe. You know, when you can enter a room, there's a vibe that you can feel that it's up. That's one way of looking at it. Another way is to actually purposely set out the environment to create that. You know, people like to have nature. Well, you know, bring in scent pot plants and flowers and ferns and trees into your office. You know, bring in random things that will make people feel good as well, that will help activate that positive emotion. So that's how you can bring positive state of mind and emotion into your business. Like I said before from the previous videos, the things that we need to understand about these pillars is that you don't need to invest a large or momentous resource in order for these pillars to happen. Small things you can do on a daily basis. So for a lot of these pillars, it's just small things consistently done is enough for a thriving culture. So how did you go? What are you doing to create positive state of mind and emotion in your business? Let me know. Leave a comment, hit the like if that's something that resonated with you. But otherwise, we can continue this conversation if you connect with me. Either way, we'll see you somewhere. And before I go, you don't have to be perfect to be amazing. Take care.